Good morning, students. Today I am going to start new chapter, chapter number 7, and the name of the chapter is percentage. Okay, in this chapter we'll understand what does percent mean, percentage means, how to convert a percentage into fraction and vice versa, and to find percentage of a given quantity. So the first question is, what does percent means? So percent means out of 100. Understand this statement with one example. If a person had rupees 100 and he spent rupees 53, it means out of 100 how much he spent? Rupees 53. Then in other terms we can also say that he has spent 53% of his money that he had. Okay, now one more example. If out of 100 small squares, 23 are colored blue, 27 are colored red, and 50 are colored yellow. Then we can say that 23% of the squares are blue. As out of 100, 23 are colored blue. So in other terms, we can also say that 23% of the squares are blue, 27% of the squares are red, and 50% of the squares are yellow. Here, 23% means we are saying out of 100, look here, out of 100, 23 are colored blue. Okay, so we are saying, in mathematical term, we are saying this statement. Okay, so 23% equals to 23 by 100, 27% is equal to 27 by 100, and 50% equals to 50 by 100. So in fraction form, we write 27% as 27 by 100. Always keep in mind, denominator is always equals to 100. Okay, 1 by 100 equals to 1%, 2 by 100 equals to 2%, 5 by 100, 5%. I hope this is clear. I hope the concept of percent is clear now. Now, we will understand how to convert a percentage into fraction. So, to convert a percentage into fraction, we write 100 in the denominator of the number and make the fraction in its lowest form. Okay, so here 16% is given. We have to convert this percentage into fraction. So the first rule is we write 100 in the denominator. Then 16 by 100, same way I written. Now what we have to do? And make the fraction in its lowest form. So how we'll do? 4 times 16 and 4 25 times 25. So here now it is not possible to cut with one table. So now 4 by 25 is the answer. I hope this is clear. Now second topic is how to convert a fraction into percentage. So now this number is given in fraction. We have to convert the fraction into percentage. So to convert a fraction into percentage, multiply the numerator by 100 and then divide by denominator. So 3 by 5, it means first we have to multiply into 100 and we have to divide by numerator. So 5, 20 times 100, and 3 into 20 equals to 60. Okay, so 60%. We converted fraction into a percentage. I hope this is clear. Now third topic, to convert a decimal into percentage. So to convert a decimal into percentage, multiply the decimal fraction by 100 or shift decimal 2 places to the right side. Very easy. Understand with here 0.3, or we can say 0.3. It means 0.3 into 100 we have to multiply with 100. And we know when we multiply with 100 we have to shift the decimal places to the two places to the right. So this is one places and one more places. So what we'll do? How we'll make another place? By adding 0. So 30.0, or we can say 30%. Okay, I hope this is clear. Understand one more example. 0.057. So 0.057 into 100 we have to shift two places to the right. It means first place and second place. After decimal, we have to shift two places to the right side. So first place and second place. So it means we have to put number after second place. It means 5.7 answer. I hope this is clear. Now last topic is to convert a percentage into decimal. Now this is written in percentage and we have to convert into decimal. 6%. Here this is written wrong. 6% means 6 by. So wait. To convert a percentage into decimal, divide the percent by 100. Or count two places from the right to the left and put the decimal. So 6%, how will divide by 100? Like this. 6 by 100. And we know denominator side two zeros are there. It means we have to count two places from the right. Here is only one place. Then how will we make two places? By adding zero. So 60 point. We put the decimal. It means 0.06 or 0.06. Both are same. 17% also same. 17 by 100. So count two places from the right to the left and put the decimal. So one or first digit, second digit, two places, and then we'll put the decimal. It means 0.17. So now come to exercise 7.1. I will solve few questions. So the first topic is, the first question is, convert the following fraction into percentage. The first question, A number 5 by 6. As we know, how we'll convert fraction into percentage? By multiply the numerator with 100. So 5 into 100 by 6, and then divide with the numerator, denominator. So 6, 2, 3 times 6 and 2, 50 times 100. Now it is not possible to cut. Then 5 into 50 equals to 250 and divided by 6. So 250 divided by 3 equals to 83 whole 1 by 3. So C divided here also. 3, 8 times 24. Sorry. So 4, 5 minus 4 equals to 1. 2 minus 2, 0. Again we will take one number now. So 3, 8 times. Sorry, 3. 3 times 9. So 10 minus. 10 minus 9 equals to 1. So 83 whole 1 by 3 is the answer. I hope this is clear. Now one more question from question number 1. That is J number. 3 by 10. Again we will do same thing. We have to write like this also. 3 by 10 into 100. Or 3 into 100 by 10. 10 times 100. So 3 into 10 equals to 30%. I hope this is clear. Now question number 2. Change the following into fraction. So it means these digits are written in percentage. It means we have to change the percentage into, or convert the percentage into fraction. Okay. So how we'll convert? By dividing with 100. So 45% equals to 45 by 100, and then we have to make the fraction into in lowest form. So I think with 5 table we will divide it. So 5, 9 times 45 and 5, 20 times 20. Now it is not possible to divide or not possible to cut to the smallest form. So 9 by 20 is the answer. In the same way, C number 33 whole 1 by 3. Okay, we will convert the
mixed fraction into improper fraction.
3 into 33 equals to 100 plus 1. So 100 by 3 divided by 100. If nothing is there, then we'll put downside 1. And it is not possible to divide like this. Then what we will do? We will change this divide into multiplication. And when we change divide into multiplication, what happened? This digit will do reverse. It means 100 by 1 we'll write as 1 by 100. Now 100 we can cut. What is left only? 1 by 3. So 1 by 3 is the answer. I hope this is clear. Now one more question. H number 11 whole 1 by 9. So 9 11s are 99 plus 1, 100. So 100 by 9, same way we'll do, divide by 100. So nothing is there. It means we have to put 1 here. So again we will change the sign, divide will convert into 100, and then what we will do, we will do reciprocal. Okay, so 100 by 9 into 1 by 100, again 100 cut, so 1 by 9 is the answer. Okay, 1 by 9 is the answer. Now question number 3, write the following percentage as decimal. All the these numbers are written in percentage, we have to convert it decimals. Okay, so how we'll convert it? By dividing 100, or we'll write denominator side 100. So 65% equals to 65 by 100, and we know 100 is there, it means we have to put, how we'll make it, or we'll form this number in decimal. We know in denominator side 2 zeros are there, so start from the right, we'll count 2 digit, and before this number we'll put decimal. So here 0.65 or 0.65, both are same. In the same way here also, one more question, 3.7. We have to convert this number percent in decimal. Okay, but 3.7 given in percent. So 3/7/100, but here is point. So how, when we remove the decimal, it means after decimal one digit here, so we will put 10. So now 37/1000. So again, now this is 37/1000. Now how many zeros are there in denominator side? 3. So start from the right, we will count 3 digit. So 1, 10 and 1 digit we don't know, then how we make? By adding 0, and we will put before that number point or decimal. So answer is 0.037, or we can say that 0.037. Both are same. Now last question is, convert the following decimal into percentage. Convert the following decimal into percentage. The first is 0.85. So we know to convert a decimal into percentage, you multiply the decimal fraction by 100, then after, or shift the decimal point, to the two places to the right side. So first divide, multiply with 100, then two zeros are there, it means we have to shift by two digit to the right side. So one digit, second digit, afterwards we'll put decimal. So if after 85 we put decimal, no, nothing is there, it means 85.0. 85.0 equals to 85%. So directly I written here 85%. I hope this is clear. And last C number, 0.001. Same way, first we will do the multiplication. So 0.001 into 100. Then again we will shift the number 2 digit to the right and put the decimal. It means we have to put here. So 0.1, or we can say that 0.1% is the answer. Okay, I hope this exercise is clear. And so those question I have not solved is your homework. Complete all this homework, work on time. Thank you.